collaborators, and they to him. There was a long period of Hal Prince, and now we are in the Sondheim James Lipton period, which has given us new miracles and a different sensibility. Lipton comes from photography and graphic design. He's avant-garde, he's a poet.
I've seen a play that he wrote and directed called 12 Dreams, and I wanted to get together with him, and he wanted to get together with me, but a mutual friend, a producer, got us together. And we just started to talk. And we started talking about paintings, and he had used the Surratt in a piece he had done up at Yale, and he said, did you ever notice there are over 50 people in it and nobody looking at anybody else? We started to speculate why that would be true. And suddenly we realized it was like, and I said, it's like a stage set, you know, it's like a French farce, isn't it? You know, maybe those people aren't supposed to be seen with each other because, you know, they're cheating on each other. And we started to talk about it and how it might make a story. And then James said, the crucial thing, he said, of course, the main character's missing. I said, who? He said, the painter. And as soon as he said that, we knew we had a show because it's about a man and his landscape. And a man who controls, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera.
This musical won what it deserved, the Pulitzer Prize for drama. Liz will sing to you the opening number, Dot. I hate that name, by the way, Dot. That's too on the nose for you.
Except, you know, it's a very French name. There are movie actresses named Dot. Dot is, yes, not Dorothy. Dot is a very French name. Okay. Sorry.
But the only thing I hate, and that the rest, I think, is beyond description. It's so good. And he's painting her. She's in a bustle and she's fastened and she can't move, and he's irritated when she does move, as you'll hear. And this begins here, once again, listen to this opening number that tells you so much in so little time.
George, why do you always get to sit in the shade while I have to stand in the sun? George! Hello, George! There is someone in this dress. A trickle of sweat. The back of the head. He always does this. Now the foot is dead. Sunday in the park with George. One more step. Collar is damp, beginning to pinch, the bustle slipping, I won't budge one inch. Who was at the zoo, George? Who was at the zoo? The monkeys and who, George? The monkeys and who?
Don't move, please.
Artists are bizarre, fixed, cold. That's you, George, you're bizarre. Fixed, cold. I like that in a man. Fixed, cold. God, it's hot out here. Well, there are worse things than staring at the water on a Sunday. There are worse things than staring at the water as you're posing for a picture being painted by your lover in the middle of the summer on an island in the river on a Sunday. Petticoats wet, which adds to the weight. The sun is blinding. All right, concentrate.
Eyes open, please.
Sunny in the park with George.
Look out at the water, not at me.
Sunny in the park with George. Concentrate, concentrate. Well, if you want bread and respect and attention, not to say connection, modeling's no profession. If you want instead, when you're dead, some more public and more permanent expression of affection, you want a painter, poet, sculptor, preferably marble, granite, bronze, durable, something nice and swans that's durable forever. George, you're gone. You're really gone. George. I love your size, George. But most, George, of all. The tip of a stay, right under the tit. No, don't give in, just lift the arm a bit.
Don't lift the arm, please.
Sunday in the park with George.
The buffalo high, please.
Not even a nod, as if I were trees. The ground could open, he would still say please. Never know with you, George. Who could know with you? The others I knew, George. Before we get through, I'll get to you too. God, I am so hot. Well, there are worse things than staring at the water on a Sunday. There are worse things than staring at the water as you're posing for a picture after sleeping on the ferry, after getting up at 7 to come over to an island in the middle of a river half an hour from the city on a Sunday.
Don't move the mouth.
George!
It's a letter of thought.
You end with a song.